A winter weather advisory is in effect until 9 a.m. It got extended from original 6 a.m., which is right now. And while the roads look clear and just wet, you're going to want to take it slow because we've had a handful of crashes, spinouts. It is freezing rain and it's metro-wide right now.
It is. And in fact, within the last few minutes, more schools have either canceled or delayed or they're moving to distance learning this morning. So if you're waking up and you weren't expecting this, you definitely want to look at the bottom of the screen. We have the schools that are canceled or delayed scrolling at the bottom there. You can always check it out at care11.com as well. So might throw a wrench into your day for sure.
Metro Transit also stopping bus service as well. So just a heads up for that. I think we're going to get to Ben. Ben first. Oh, no, we're following breaking news. Yes, this just came in. A live picture from Newark Airport. All flights in the U.S. have been grounded due to a computer outage. This is according to the Federal Aviation Administration. Technicians are currently working to restore the system, but there's no estimated time for when that might happen. We're monitoring things here at Twin Cities International. And of course, we're going to keep you posted. But again, all flights have been grounded.
Hearing from people on Twitter saying that they were at the airport currently for a 5:25 a.m. flight to Chicago. The gate areas and restaurants are jam-packed. A brief announcement came around 4:45. Otherwise, there's been very little info from the airlines because I'm sure they don't know either. So everything's showing on time then still, he's saying, and people are still showing up. So
I don't remember the last time this happened. So it's definitely, I'm sure people at airports are currently like, well, what's going on? They're grounded across the country.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, it is. We'll stay on top of that, Ben.
Yeah. I wonder if they just tried, you know, unplugging the computer and plugging it back in again. It usually works for me.
That's what the IT department says, right?
More of a serious situation there. And yeah, on the roads, it's pretty serious as well. We've been talking about freezing rain all morning. It's been falling since just after midnight. And the back edge of this just now moving through the west and southwest metro right now. That means the accumulating freezing rain is going to be coming to a close. However, temperatures are still colder than freezing. So any rain that falls is going to immediately freeze to a layer of ice. So that's what we're dealing with on the roads this morning. Now, temperatures are forecast to warm up. We should be back above the freezing mark late this morning into early this afternoon. But that low hanging overcast is going to continue, and not to mention bad air quality. We'll talk more about that in Maine weather. But first, here's a look at your roads this morning. Alicia.
Not great, Ben, on the roads. Unfortunately, that freezing rain is making quite the mess. In fact, we have a completely rolled over vehicle, as you can see here, 494 at 49th Avenue out of the Invergrove area. As you can see that sheen on the roadways. Don't let it fool you. Roads aren't wet. They're icy. It's like an ice rink across the Twin Cities Metro this morning. As you see, mostly red or yellow, which is extremely slow for the morning commute, especially south of us where that freezing rain is still coming down. A few crashes into St. Paul 35E and then 169 at 101 just so happened to be a hot spot. We had a jackknife semi blocking the shoulder there as well. So just a heads up for that. And then the only road closure for now, Highway 7 westbound out of Shorewood is closed due to a jackknife semi there. And all morning long, we've been warning you just how icy it is. So let's get to Cece Gaines, who's live in Minneapolis with more on the road conditions. Hey, Cece.
Hey, Alicia. Yeah, just to mimic what Alicia's been saying, the roads not great this morning. It was a very slow crawl getting here maybe an hour and a half ago. We were going very slow, definitely under 30, just because you could just be driving and veer off because the roads are so slick. But here where we are on Lyndale Avenue in Minneapolis, the roads are slushy and wet on this part of town for sure. But there's also ice underneath, so it's not just that wet, as we've been saying this morning. So definitely be careful with that. And I know we mentioned earlier about Metro Transit suspending buses, and a lot of people, like I said last hour, they're still choosing to walk now that the buses didn't come on time because of that suspension and the icy road conditions and everything. So just be aware of that. But we have seen some snowplows out and about putting down salt and getting out on the roads. But even with the snowplows out, we saw them going very, very slow as well. So if they're going slow, us in cars and SUVs, we need to go slow too. So that's the name of the game this morning. If you can leave early, I would try to do that this morning, guys.
All right, Cece Gaines reporting live for us. Thanks for that report.
And this morning, you're also waking up to another air quality alert. Parts of the Twin Cities Metro and Moorhead are in the red, which is unhealthy for everyone, while central and northwestern Minnesota are orange. For now, you should reduce outdoor activities, especially rigorous ones. And people, of course, with underlying conditions like asthma or heart disease are the ones who are most at risk. And as you're grabbing your things to leave for the day, you'll want to download the Care 11 weather app, especially with everything that's going on right now. No matter where you are, you can get personalized forecasts and you can check live radar. It is free wherever you get your apps. Well, this morning, another family is looking for justice. North High School student athlete Deshaun Hill was shot and killed a year ago next month. His family says he was let out of school by his principal to attend a protest for a deadly police shooting. However, investigators say he was in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Yeah, now Hill's family is settling with the Minneapolis School District. Danny Spiewak shares the deal and new reaction this morning.
Director Abdi, will you please move approval on these items?
Almost 3 hours into Tuesday night's meeting and with no public discussion.
All those in favor say aye.
The Minneapolis School Board.
That motion carries and the consent agenda is approved.
A $500,000 settlement with the family of Deshaun Hill in exchange for the family dropping all legal claims against the school district. Hill was shot last February 9th at Penn Avenue North and Golden Valley Road in North Minneapolis. During the school day, but away from school grounds. Prosecutors charged 30-year-old Cody Forenkamp with second-degree murder, alleging that he fired at Hill after the two possibly brushed shoulders. Hill's family told Care 11 shortly after his death that he may have been on his way to catch a city bus to attend a Justice for Amir Locke rally at City Hall, along with other North High classmates who left school early during a walkout.
I dropped my kids off at school. I picked them up from school because I don't want them to I didn't want this to happen, and look what happened.
Ahead of Tuesday's settlement vote, the family's attorney released a statement. The attorney placed blame on North High principal Mari Freeslaven, arguing that, quote, if that principal had not released the children over the instruction of the district, D. Hill would be alive today. Freeslaven declined comment on the settlement. The district, meanwhile, said in a statement after the vote that, quote, while the school district denied all liability, it reached a settlement with the family, and that final approval of the settlement will be handled by the Hennepin County District Court.
How's Danny Spiewak reporting? Now, all of this is going on with the school district. There's also a criminal case still playing out. Cody Forenkamp will stand trial for murder next week, starting with jury selection on the 17th. Well, the boyfriend of the pregnant woman shot and killed at the Lakeville Amazon warehouse is now charged with second-degree murder.
The criminal complaint says Dante McCray and Kyla O'Neill had just broken up, but she still drove him to work. He says he pointed what he thought was an unloaded gun and fired, hitting her in the neck. Prosecutors believe it was intentional. O'Neill was 9 months pregnant, and the baby, Messiah, was delivered but is now in critical condition. Prosecutors say they will add another charge if the baby does not survive. This morning, O'Neill's family is speaking out. Her sister says there was an altercation earlier in the day after McCray admitted to infidelity. It did not realize that, of course, it would lead to her sister's death.
He went in the back of her car, in her back door, and grabbed her gun out of her purse and aimed it at her and shot her.
The family says doctors are now running tests on the baby. They will know Friday whether or not they will have to take him off life support. A GoFundMe has also been set up to assist Katina, that is her mother, as she takes care of O'Neill's other three children. All right, a live look this morning. This is the story of the day. Freezing rain. This is in our parking lot here at Care 11. You can see that sheen, that coating of ice. Producer Jess, she is scraping windows right now. Maybe scraping windows.
She's
right
taking
now.
A break.
She's taking a break. She's tired. Jess is tired. Not only are you going to wake up to this if you park outside, but if you have to go anywhere today, you definitely want to take your time because the commute is incredibly, incredibly slow. And it is also, of course, filled with spinouts and crashes.
Oh, that's the worst when the scraper doesn't even work.
Yeah.
It's just going on top of the ice there, Ben.
Yeah, you need heavy duty scrapers to get that ice off. A credit card is not going to work today. And even those heavy duty scrapers are having a tough time. So you're going to add some time to your morning commute, not just in the drive, but scraping off your windshield if you're parked outside this morning. Live look at radar. You can see the freezing rain just about to wrap up right now, at least over the West Metro. Winter weather advisory has been extended until 9 a.m. today, and you can see some counties are starting to erode that over the central and western part of the state, but it stays into effect until 9 a.m. here around the Twin Cities. And around the region, we still have this low-hanging overcast, and temperatures are just barely colder than freezing. So this rain is falling down, and right before it hits the ground, it's falling through a layer that's now colder than freezing. So that liquid water turns to supercooled water. That's water that's colder than freezing, which does exist. And then as soon as it hits something hard, like a surface or a car or a road, it freezes instantly. At least that's what happens when temperatures are colder than freezing. On top of the freezing rain, we also have bad air quality that continues today. If you notice, we didn't clear out yesterday. The wind didn't pick up at all. So we continue with poor air quality through the rest of the day today. Orange and red indicates unhealthy for sensitive groups, and the red indicates unhealthy air for everybody. So if you're waking up and maybe feeling a little icky this morning, that might be one of the reasons why. Air quality alert continues until 6 p.m. today for all the counties highlighted in gray. Stagnant air, which should improve as we head into tomorrow. That's when the wind is forecast to pick up. That mixing of the air will help to improve air quality and also pull in some colder conditions. 33 for a high today, back in the 20s Thursday and Friday, and cooling off, but we should see a brighter day on Friday, and overall a quiet and mostly cloudy weekend ahead. Here's Alicia with a look at the roads.
Yeah, unfortunately still dealing with a lot of crashes. This one just happened here moments ago. A car completely spun around on Highway 10 as folks are getting towards the Moundsview area at Airport Road. Also a reminder of what not to do. If you do happen to get in a crash or spin out, stay in your car. These two gentlemen seem to have gotten out of the car, and there's cars flying by, flying past them. So again, just another spin out to talk about this morning. As you can see, there's a lot of crash icons and spin outs and jackknife semis we've been dealing with throughout the morning. In fact, a jackknife semi is the reason for a closure west of us here. Highway 7 westbound at 41 still closed. As you can see, eastbound side is open. But if you are maybe going west on 7 this morning, just a heads up, because that might be closed for the time being this morning, Rena.
All right. Well, today, students at the University of Idaho are back on campus for the first time since an arrest was made for their classmates' murders. After the break, we hear how students returning to class feel now about their safety.
Right now, gyms across the metro have been packed with people trying to stick to their New Year's resolutions to work out. And if you're about to get your sweat on this morning, we have some etiquette tips you might want to be aware of. Gym etiquette. I need to learn that, I think.